Thank you very much to the senior management of Naledi for welcoming us here at your facility, the executive chairperson, the group CEO, and all the other senior managers, and to all the staff of the Department of Trade and Industry. We are happy to be here. We have a program at DTI called Taking DTI to the Factories. We have sought to come to these facilities ourselves to see, especially those that we are interacting with, whether they are applying for incentives, whether they have received the incentives, just to make sure that indeed there is a factory and there is some work happening. So we are here to see that, and I'm encouraged. I can tell there is a factory here. So we really wanted to see for ourselves the operation, interact with senior management, get to hear what are the challenges and so on. I am aware that in February this year, you put an application for AIS incentive. And I have been trying to check with my team. They said that it has gone through adjudication, so in good time they will come back to you. So I don't know whether they will say yes or no, but at least it has gone through their processes. So, and I hope that after this visit, we should be able to come back to you to say what happened to your application. And the chair was very specific that at the time of IDC, when it was under our authority, it did give some part funding to the institution as we're working on the transformation program. We just thought that it is important that let's come and get to understand what exactly do you do, what sort of programs are in place to try and catch up with some of the new policy developments of government. As you will know that we are now busy championing beyond BEE, a policy on black industrialists, where basically we're looking at having a number of entrepreneurs who are majority black, who are learning the trade within the productive sector of the economy, who can actively participate and ensure that they are involved in enterprises for a longer time to ensure that we can ensure inclusive economic growth in South Africa. So we're happy to see the diversity of the team, from the chair to the operations to even money. Indeed, there is a very strong attempt from your side to look into issues of empowerment. What we wanted to do specifically was just to explain that starting from August, when last year we made a pronouncement that we are going to create about 100 black industrialists, and we had to be seized with an opportunity to work extensively with the team, firstly to consult, but also to write a policy which we are now ready to take to cabinet. There are two things in that specific policy. The first thing is that we have been galvanizing support from all our DFIs, and we have agreed with them to sign MOUs and ring-fence certain funding from PIC, IDC, NEF, DBSA, Land Bank, and all of them. So we have agreed to make particular funding available for a range of things for the development of enterprises. And we hope that companies like yourselves can be able to look into those funding and begin to see how do you tap into them to ensure that you grow your business even much bigger. The second thing that we have been doing in this program, over and above just writing the policy, has been to go to all our SOEs, the state-owned enterprises, as well as key infrastructure department, to say to them, what is the opportunity value that can be ring-fenced and made available for black industrialists? And we have a sense that a number of SOEs, as well as key departments, are beginning to come forward to make that opportunity available. And we hope that you will benefit. You will know that over the next 5 years, government has committed to spend about 5 trillion rand buying goods and services, especially around the infrastructure and built environment. And we believe that as a foundry, you've got a role to play in the space to ensure that we continue to deliver services as government. So this program has become important. There are two unique features about it as compared to our BEE, which we still endorse. Those that we support, we want them to be longer in the business, 10 years and plus, But at the point of them wanting to sell, executive chair, would want you to sell to her if she's not yet a shareholder. Don't sell to Mr. Smith. So that's the program, because we have seen that we have reversed some of the transactions because we did not, in the process, build people who were capable to take charge of these enterprises, because we also don't want to lock you in a business even when you want to walk away. So, but also, the issues of transformation then becomes important that we carry them through over time. And I'm encouraged to know that the IEDC own 40% of the business, and in time we should be able to talk to them to relinquish that particular percentage to many shareholders, so that we have an enterprise that is purely run by majority black of our people here. So we are here for that specific reason, and I will really encourage to hear a presentation, what exactly is happening here in terms of your product, in terms of your outlook, in terms of where you want to expand your markets in South Africa and outside our borders, so that we begin to share with you some of the plans that we have in terms of how we would want to place companies like yourselves into some of the international platforms that we have as Department of Trade and Industry. And my colleagues at the technical level are here to explain some of the issues, be it incentives and other work that we're doing, to ensure that you are enlightened as the company. And lastly, I want to take this opportunity to congratulate this company, Naledi, for having saved so many jobs that South Africa needs, because this is very, very important for us. That is why that we continuously say that we want inclusive growth that results in job creation. So if we can sustain jobs here, and if we can expand your factory, and we have no doubt that you could be able to do that through our intervention, and we would want you to ensure that you protect workers in the factory, because that is important in the work we do. But thank you very much.